Welcome back to the adventure. Today we're doing an intermediate level multi-boot setup with MS-DOS 6.22, Windows for Workgroups 3.11, Windows 98, and Windows 2000. This starts out similar to the dual boot setup we did previously. Next, we need to partition the hard drive. We can create a primary partition that is at most 2 GB in capacity. This is where DOS, Windows 3.11, and Windows 98 will reside, as they are particular about being on the first 2 GB of the hard drive. Reboot the computer for the changes to take effect. Then we need to format the drive. No special consideration here. Using /s won't make a difference because we're going to be installing MS-DOS, and the auto test switch is personal preference. Then we need to set up MS-DOS 6.22 with the standard method using the 3 floppy disk set. No configuration changes are needed. The default directory, keyboard, language, etc. are all fine. Now to install Windows for Workgroups 3.11. We can use our newfangled installation CD, which is available on archive.org. A card will appear for a video that goes into more details about what's on the installation disk. The important step during installation is the path. All versions of Windows want to install in the Windows folder or directory, so we need to change the installation path to /C:\Win311. All of the other settings are fine. Just let the installation wrap up here. We're going to skip installing printers and the network driver and all that good stuff. Next up is installing Windows 98. You may be wondering why we skip over Windows 95 in the multi-boot setup. The reason for this is the boot menu, like what we have in Windows 98, is broken in Windows 95, so we would lose the ability to return to pure DOS. Similar to what we had to do with Windows 3.11, we need to adjust the install path. This time, we'll make it C:\Win98. No other changes need to be made. Eventually, we will do an answer file to speed up the installation process, or at least generate less prompts. You may have noticed that I didn't copy the cab files over to the hard drive before installing Windows 98. It's not necessary, but it does have several benefits. It's something that we'll be building into a batch file for installing the multi-boot system in a later video. Once we are at the desktop, we'll need to modify a few files so we have the option to return to DOS. Open Explorer. Now go to the View menu and select Folder Options. Go to the second tab, also called a View, and make sure that the following entries are marked. Allow all uppercase names, display the full path in the title bar, select Show All Files in the Hidden Files section, and uncheck Hide File Extensions for Known File Types. From here, locate msdos.sys on the root of C. Right-click on it and select Properties. Uncheck Read Only, then click Apply. Now we can open msdos.sys in Notepad. We need to have 3 lines in the file. Boot multi equals 1. Boot menu equals 1, and boot GUI equals 1. Don't forget to add the read-only property back to msdos.sys. And then now we're free to do the Windows 2000 installation. But first, we have to make an adjustment in our virtual machine. There is a problem that occurs when installing Windows 2000 in VirtualBox. The Windows 2000 installation will crash at the end of the GUI phase of the setup. Instead of rebooting into Windows for the first time, setup will restart at the beginning of the GUI phase. There is a bug in the hard disk driver for Windows 2000, where the hardware interrupt from the IDE controller can happen too soon and cause the operation to fail. This can be fixed by adding an IRQ delay in VirtualBox. It's done through a VBox manage command in the command prompt, and the command will be included down in the description. On to installing Windows 2000. Pretty standard install process. I'm going to create a 2GB partition for data that all of the operating systems can read from and write to. Then create the partition we will be installing Windows 2000 on. For the format, we will choose NTFS. We can technically let Windows 2000 take the traditional Windows folder, unless you plan on adding additional versions of Windows. Again, no other settings need to be changed from the default. Per usual, we want to choose custom for the installation type, so we can at least see what the default settings are. A note about using the NTFS format. DOS, Windows 3X, and Windows 9X won't be able to read from that partition, at least not without modification, which is something we'll discuss in a later video. Now for booting up the system after all of the operating systems are installed. The boot menu we have has a few layers. The first layer we have here allows us to choose between Windows 2000 and Windows 98. If we choose Windows 98, we get a second boot menu, which allows us to choose between Windows 98 and DOS. If we choose DOS, we can then type Win at the prompt and access Windows 3.11. All right, we have a fully functioning multi-boot setup with MS-DOS 6.22, Windows for Workgroups 3.11, Windows 98, and Windows 2000. What should we do next? Let me know down in the comments. Thanks for stopping by. See you next video.